Hi guys, this is Ajuga, and today we're going to talk about some ISO basics concepts like what is public IP, what are static IP, what are reserved IPs, and instance level public IP. And we'll know how to set them using PowerShell. And these actually are various types of IPs which exist on Azure, and I'll try to explain them in a simple way. Hope you like it. Thank you. So guys, let's get started. So before this, we'll be setting up the complete Azure PowerShell so that even the beginners who couldn't set up Azure PowerShell can do this, because the normal PowerShell wouldn't have the commandlets which actually used by Azure, or the other commandlets which will not be populated in PowerShell. So PowerShell libraries need to be populated with this Azure libraries as well. So for this, you can see that I have mentioned a link below, which I would be posting in the comment section as well. You just need to click this particular link and go through the video, and where he will be explaining how to install Azure PowerShell. So it's the same PowerShell. On top of it, it would just push using a web platform installer. If you don't have a web platform installer, it will install the web platform installer as well. And then after installing web platform installer, you need to search about Microsoft Azure PowerShell. So what it would do is, like, whatever the PowerShell is a default installation which comes with Windows machines. So the Microsoft Azure PowerShell would add few libraries or commandlets to it so that you can make calls, or you can use those PowerShell commandlets. And alternatively, that would the PowerShell would make a REST API call to Azure. So this would be possible once you get authenticated, like you add subscription, everything, then only it happens. So you can see that after installing, you can use either PowerShell ISC or Windows PowerShell. I'll be using ISC to demonstrate run certain scripts. The ISC would be having two particular sections: one is text editor and another is the command line. And So you can see that whenever you after you install Azure PowerShell, you first need to add Azure account so that it would authenticate your credentials. It will pop up for your credentials, and once you enter your credentials, you will add the Azure account to your Azure PowerShell window. And then if you have multiple commandlets, you will be prompted for select Azure subscription. So the same things would be doing, and I'll be showing, and we will run few of PowerShell commandlets. So what is public IP? So when it comes to public IP, it says that the IP which is exposed to public, and we'll know like how to set and remove them. And so public IPs are like, these are the virtual IPs, or the VIP. It's an IP address of cloud service or a public endpoint of a virtual machine. So you can ping these endpoints. Example, if a cloud service, then it would be, the URL would be the azureguy.cloudapp.net. You can ping this, you will get the public IP. So ping, you just type ping azureguy.cloudapp.net, you'll get the public IP. If you want to RDP into a VM behind a cloud service, use the, let me take a pointer. If you want to RDP into a VM behind the cloud service, you need to use a public IP plus a port number, the RDP port number, which is basically 3389, and you can RDP into any of the VMs which are hosted on Azure. So let's go for a demo. So you can see I have two VMs here. And as you know that in ASM, it would create cloud service, corresponding cloud service to it. Since I created a VM called as the Azure Guy VM1, and I have been creating it repeatedly, that's why it had assigned me a cloud service named the Azure Guy VM14091 something, a different code, because already people would have tried with this particular name. So I got allotted with this particular random number. So cloud service would, the IP which cloud service would be having, the would be the cloud service IP is our public endpoint or the public IP. You can see the Azure Guy VM14091.cloudapp.net. Let's ping this IP. You can ping this IP using a PowerShell, or you can use, let's clear the screen. Yes, thing. Remove this. The HTTP codes. And just ping. You'll get the public IP. The IP is 52.163. Just go and check this particular IP. It should be there. So when you go to cloud service, let's go to the dashboard. You can see the public IP, the cloud service IP, which is given here, and the cloud service IP. You can go here and you can check the public service, public IP as well, 52.163.126.183, which we resoluted back from command line as well. Partial. You can see here, 52.162.126.163. So you can ping these particular cloud service or the VMs behind them. So when you ping a cloud service, you'll get the status. If one, at least one instance is there, you'll get a response back. And just go to virtual machines. You have the virtual, you have your virtual machines here. So you can have various types of, so when you present, so you can see the public IP. This is the public IP or the VIP address we say, and we'll come to know what is, what are internal IP addresses. So that's what's public IP address. And let's go, let's learn about what is static IP and how to set and remove them. So this is the partial script. The static IP is like you'll be setting an IP as static. So basically the IPs which are allotted to on a VM are dynamic. So we can set them as an IP and we can set them as static so that these IPs doesn't change. So let's see. So for, as I said, like after creating or installing Azure Partial, you need to have, you need to first add get Azure account, which is this get Azure account. You run, I have already run. And if you have multiple subscriptions, you need to select Azure subscription. You just run this, you will prompt, you will get prompt with, let me show that as well. You'll be prompt with subscription name. So let's add get Azure account. Let's add, let me show you from starting. So when you say get Azure account, it would prompt you if you are, if you have not logged into this particular session. And you can see that I have logged in with my user ID, my subscription ID is this, and I'm a tenant since everything in Azure or every customer in Azure is a tenant. That's my tenant ID and this is my subscription and type is a user. And after you get Azure account, you can then select Azure subscription. So you will be prompted for the subscription name. And you can get the subscription name from the Azure portal. There's the old ASM portal. You can see it says that Visual Studio Devs Essential. That's your subscription name. Just come, paste your name. And it would accept or it would select Visual Studio Essentials. If you wouldn't do that, then if your pay-as-you-go account is selected, then it would create up resources in that pay-as-you-go account. So once that is done, so for setting up a static IP would be set upon a VNet because your VM would be a part of a subnet and that subnet would be part of a VNet. So that's prerequisite, which is a compulsory here, is you need to have a subnet assigned to a VM and that should be part of a VNet. So once that is done, you can use something called as set Azure VNet config and you can set up this particular setup internal IP to static from dynamic. So what we'll be doing is like we will be setting up, we'll be using our, there are two ways which we can do this stuff, is via using a Azure Partial and using portal. the new portal or the ARM portal. So let's go and let's do this stuff. I'll be taking the VM name. So these are the basic parameters which would be required. The VM name is VM1. I'll save it. And the same, the service name, the cloud service name is as well. But the cloud service name, it's not VM1. It's something different. So it's called for the VM1. The cloud service name is, as you guys, this particular path. I'll just select it, paste it. And the IP which we need to make it as static. I'll be doing this. Let's go here. Let's get the internal IP. So this is the internal IP for which we're gonna do this as a static. This is internal to ensure and people can, so it's the same 10.0.4 and the variable we create is a VM variable which will get the get issue VM service with the service name called as a cloud service name. So let's run these particular parameters first. Run this parameter. The parameter ran successfully. Let's go and set. There's a static. Okay, before that, if you want to see whether it's already not set to static, just go to the issue guy VM1 and in the new portal, go to the IP address exchange, and you can see that it's dynamic in nature. The IP address is dynamic. Sorry, this one. The IP address is dynamic. So after changing, it should set to static. Let's go back. Let's run our script. So it says set as your static VNet IP. It takes IP address, it's take a VM details, and it's updates that Azure VM. So we ran the command. We should get results. What happens is, like, whenever the static IP is set, after that static IP is set, the VM should restart again or start up again. So after our command successfully runs, we should see automatically this partial should trigger, internally trigger after the static IP. IP is turned from dynamic to static, it would restart this particular VM. Still our script is running. Yes, that's the operation is succeeded. We should see this starting at any moment. You can see updating IP address. Since when you make the IP address from static to or from dynamic to static, so what happens in dynamic, it would the virtual machines would get IP from a DHCP dynamically, and these IPs can change at any moment. But when you make it static, so you can see this, it's after triggering the script, it's showing the updating IP address and it made static. So our IP would be 10.0.0.4 would be static, and you can try to RDP this particular IP directly. Since, and it won't change until unless you are reverted back. You can see the script had triggered starting. The status has changed. The VM is starting again, and what it would do is, like, it would get the particular IP which we have mentioned as static as a permanent IP till we remove it. Let's go and let's do the same stuff via Azure portal. You just need to go, let's go to Azure VM2 from the new portal, go to the IP address. It's very simple, you just need to make from dynamic to static. And if it's a part of a subnet, you can change the IP, you can change any other numbers if you wish, and you just save it. That's it. It will update the IP. So this is how you set an IP, and I'll teach you how to reset the IP. You will be taking up, we'll relinquish the IP. We'll be using the same parameters here. It's for the same VM for which we have set, we'll be releasing it. So let's run the parameters again, and I know that these variables would be stale. Already run. Let's run again. Not a problem. It will just overwrite the same variables. So I'll be running remove IP, remove static as static VNet IP. Trap. I'm running remove static as static IP. You can see after changing in the portal and the ASM ARM portal, we changed from dynamic to static for the VM2. It triggered a restart as well. You can see here that the status is changing. You can check the status here. You can see it is starting. So now I have triggered remove static IPs for this. So let's go and check that if it has changed back to dynamic or not. I'm waiting for it. Yes, it's updated. I have triggered for VM1 and it is changed to dynamic. Now it has changed back to dynamic from static. So that's how you set up static or dynamic VIP and dynamic IPs. Let's go and turn back this IP as well, the VM2 IP as well, to dynamic, which will remove the static IP. I'll make dynamic. Since that in the progress, it would take time. Okay, in that time, let's go to the next topic. So this is a script we have used for setting up the same script would be available in a GitHub repo, which I'll be sharing at the end of the discussions. So what is a reserved IP and how to set and remove them? We'll talk about it. So reserved IPs are nothing but you have a public IP and you're gonna reserve it. You can reserve a public IP. For that, you need to use partial only. The only way which is available right now at present when I'm making this video is using a partial. There are no alternatives. And the maximum limit of reserving and getting a reserve IPs are 20 in number per subscription. You reserve public IPs in cases where you need to give a specific IP of VM to your SSL provider to tag to a CNAME. Like for setting, if you're setting up a like safe connection, like SSL certificate is needed to set up a secure connection with your customer and your between your application, then you would be requiring this kind of reserve IPs concept. You can allot reserve IPs to only a service, or I mean, you can apply on a cloud service itself. You can't apply on a instance. So this comes with a price to pay than public IP. So this is not for free. So the script which goes like this is reserved IP is set at subscription level. First out for reserve IP and then assigned, create a new deployment. So you can't create a new, you can't add a reserve IP to existing deployment. Rather, you get a reserve IP first and then you assign this particular reserve IP to any of your deployment afterwards. So you would create, you would use the ISO commandlet like new ISO reserved IP, which would take reserved IP name. You will give your custom name and then the location, since this is a region based and subscription based, that's why it would require or prompt for a location as well. So once you run that, you can confirm with get ISO reserved IP whether you got what is the reserved IP you got. And you can remove reserved IP using this particular keyword. So let's go for the lab session. And let's see the VM2 had went. And you can see I have set it to dynamic. And what I'll do is I'll save it. And it would update my VM2 from static to dynamic back. So when you come for a reserved IP, as discussed, you need to run this. You need to get a reserved IP for this. You need to run new reserved IP. And after you run the new Azure reserved IP, Azure would give you a new reserved IP with the name which you customize, like Azure Guy VM1 RIP. Let's wait for some time for the reserved IP to come. come up. After that, we can get the details, get a resort IP, which will give you the resort IP which you have created. Yes, we got our resort IP. Okay, that's there. It threw some error. So I have tried to use this particular VM1 earlier. So let's try doing 1-1 and run it again. Stop it. Let's run the script again. So as you can see that I'm starting, I just changed the name of the reserved IP which I got previously. That's why it would have thrown an error. I tried to change the name and put it back again. Let's see whether this succeeds or not. So what Azure would do when you say a reserve IP, then it would give an IP that's specifically reserved for you, and you can use this IP and set to a cloud service. You can see here, so you have a cloud service, you can use this particular IP, reserved IP, and tag it to your public IP, public or VIP address. So we can see that we have run new Azure reserved IP, reserved IP name, VM1 trip, and that's how you get your reserved IP. So once you get the reserved IP, you can check more details by get Azure reserved IP, and it would provide you certain details like where exactly which region it got this particular one, for which location, and in use or not, it's in use or not, it's assigned to a service or not, it shows false, your operation ID for have you got, and the IP address. So you can remove the reserved IP using this particular commandlet. I'll run it. It will say yes and let it run. Since the reserved IPs would cost you much, so you need to pay extra than the public IPs, so you won't let your bill to come up, and you just remove them from your subscriptions whenever not in use. So for a trial account which I use, or a 1 year subscription of Dev Essentials account which I'm using, I won't be interested in keeping these reserved IPs for a longer time. I'll just remove it. You can see the operation got succeeded. So let's go to the next topic. So we completed Azure Resort IP, and we'll be learning about what is instance level public IP and how to set them and remove them. So instance level IPs are the IPs of particular VM, which used to be called as PIP or public IP previously. You can remote into this particular VM directly using this instance level IPs without using a public IPs, which are the VIPs, VIPs. You can directly give the access this, but give this IP address to your SQL teams, so that the people who maintain the data layers, like the patch maintenance or any code updates, they can do this particular by RDPing using this particular instance level IP directly. So instead of you giving a public IP and then they're trying to go via public IP, which would create a little latency and delay in the service access, they can directly use it using that ILPIP. This also need to be comes with a price to pay. You can reserve, you can, I won't say a reserve, it's like you can make this instance level IP from static to dynamic, from dynamic to static, so that you can access them at any time. So for this particular, you need to run the script like something called as set Azure public IP. So the public IP name you need to mention, and you just need to update the VM. So let's go. Let's run a script. So we will be running on VM1, the same thing. So let's go and copy our parameters, required parameters. And we just need a VM name, and we doesn't need IP. We remove the IP. We just take the service name, and we just run this particular parameters first. Once the parameters get succeeded, we'll be running our set issue public IP. Let's go. Let's run this set issue public IP. This should get succeed. Let's log in. Let's check our resources. And we have these two instances. So these are the IP addresses. So you can see the instance level IP address would change once if this is for VM2, and this should be on after the script gets succeeded. We just go and grab the instance one, go to the IP address section, and you can see a script would have succeeded. Yes, it succeeded, and you can see the instance level IP address, it's on. And this particular IP, you can give it to your SQL team or other teams who actually deals with this particular VM. And this IP would be, it won't time out, and this particular IP would be assigned to this particular VM until unless you have this VM up and running and you have not shut it down or deallocated. And this IP you can give, and you can increase the idle timeout for how many minutes it should be there. You can mention them. So this is the way, and this was a partial way. And if you want to do the same in a ARM way, then you just go. Let's go. Come to VM2 IP addresses. You just make it on. So you can increase the idle timeout. You just save it. That would do every step. So you just go and go back, and I'll try to remove all the, because it cost me. I'll just make it off and I'll save it. So this would update. That's it. Update back. So this is what we learned about the instance level public IP, and this particular scripts are available in the Azure Gaia repo and the Git. You can access the link. I'll paste the same in the comment section. And if you have any more questions, please ping or tweet me at the Azure Gaia 007. I'll love to answer them as soon as possible. Thank you.
There's turkey in the oven, the mashed potatoes bubbling, watching football with our family and our friends. We smell the food a-cooking, and Grandpa keeps a-looking. Grandma pushes him out of the kitchen again. The little cousins, they all zoom, screaming loud from room to room. We don't seem to care.